It is very rare that spine surgery is a must-have. Number of times I look at somebody and say, oh, you have to have an operation on your spine or something bad is going to happen, those are relatively few and far between. Most times, spine surgery is an option for the patient, usually pursued after they've tried non-surgical measures such as physical therapy, maybe therapeutic injections, but ultimately the decision lies with the patient in terms of their pain, how it's impacting their quality of life and their activities of daily living. I can tell you whether surgery is feasible or not. I can talk about risks or benefits, but the ultimate decision lies with the patient.
No weakness.
Okay. How are you doing with pain medication?
There are different types of surgery for different areas of the spine. There are minimally invasive procedures where we can remove discs that are pressing on nerves because they're herniated, either in the lower back or in the neck. And those have essentially come down mostly to same-day surgical procedures. There are more extensive operations where you're dealing with more arthritic changes in either the neck or the lower back that require more aggressive surgery in terms of the dissection, in terms of the bone removed and the number of levels involved. And that may require a brief hospital stay, especially in the senior age categories. And then there are the construction projects where we actually have to do a fair amount of work. These are patients that have instability in their spine, that have compromise of the spinal cord or of the nerves coming out of the spine, where we have to do a lot of work. And sometimes that requires support for the spine during the healing process. For patients that don't get better, there are implants like spinal cord stimulators, pain pumps, all for the control of chronic ongoing pain. So on the off chance that the surgery doesn't work for the patient, and there's never a guarantee that it will, there may be other options that we can pursue to try and improve the patient's quality of life.